So we have some pretty big news coming up for Bleach coming this month of May of 2023. And today with me, because I feel like I can't really stretch out this video long enough, I have Flame of Rebirth. Give yourself a hello.
What's going on, people? It's your boy Flame of Rebirth here to introduce... Oh, fuck. I fucked it. What's going on, people? It's your boy Flame of Rebirth, and I'm here to introduce your boy James into the world of Cubology. So thank you for having me. I hope we have some fun.
Okay. Yeah, you just had to slide that in there. So join us throughout this video as we talk about the highs and lows of Bleach, what to expect this month, and some potential really big things that you may or may not know about. Let's get into it. So to start off, let's talk about, first and foremost, the Blu-ray sales, because of course we have the Oricon sales outlets that came out, and it is very impressive to say the least, given its context. Now, of course, the Bleach Blu-ray sold about 2,000, maybe a little bit more, but of course it's depending on which distributor, whether it's Animate or online distributors, whether that's from the online store for Piro or Amazon, so to say. So, but there could be way more outlets, and I do believe that it is way more than 2,000, even more than 2,500, and I'd even argue even into the 3,000 mark. But of course, with that context being, of course, the box set being about, what, $200, give or take?
$250 for me. I think I got a bad deal.
There you go. that shipping. So, yeah. So considering about close to $200, which is a lot in especially American terms and even UK terms, which is about 180, 150, something along those lines, you have to also take into consideration too, because people are like, oh, well, Bocchi the Rock obviously clears Bleach and it sells well. Here's a little bit of context. The same month that Bleach actually dropped was the same month or even the same week that Bleach, the original box set 3, which included the fake Karakura Town War arc and also the Fullbring arc in Blu-ray, that also dropped. And that was about $200-ish as well, and that sold unbelievably well as well, because that was also within the charts of Oricon. So you have, give or take, people that are buying $400 worth of Bleach within a single month in box set forms, and I think that sold about 700 copies as well. So that's not really a number to sniff at all. So what do you think about those numbers?
I, for one, I think it's great that Bleach is selling so well. People, it's crazy, but there are still people out there who thought that Bleach didn't have the legs to be this popular, to go this far. And it's great that the box sets of the prior iteration of Bleach, the old anime, is selling, and that the new one is so sought after. $250 is not a lot, you know, including shipping. That I spent, it takes a lot to believe that it's worth it. And I give credit to the anime team and Studio Pierrot. They made it worth buying. It would have been a different conversation if it wasn't worth the money. In this case, Bleach certainly is.
So yeah, when we look at, you know, when we're going to compare it to Chainsaw Man or compare it to Bocchi, or even, you know, comparing it to be like, oh, well, it didn't reach top one. It still reached top 10% or top 10 in terms of the sales. And that's really good. And I think it's a really good reflection for Aniplex, for Piro, because at the end of the day, it's money like that. Even if you consider the 2,000 mark a small number, considering the price of these box sets, which again is quite, you know, expensive, if it was like, you know, maybe $20 or $30 or even $50, then maybe we could be like, maybe it didn't do that well. But considering the price point of this, it gives Aniplex and Piro, even Shueisha, to look at these numbers and be like, hey, you know, this is still a very profitable series, and they're gonna want more of that Bleach bag later on. And that's why we look at these numbers. This is why we care about the Blu-ray sales, because many people are like, oh, well, you know, if we don't care about the Chainsaw Man sales, why should we care about the Bleach ones? And at the end of the day, yeah, like, Disney put in their money towards Bleach, but as well, you know, having this much money go into a DVD or Blu-ray box set as well is very telling to how much of a market there is for Bleach and how much Aniplex do want to probably gravitate towards that later on. So even though, again, DVD and Blu-rays don't really matter, it's the point of the consumership that does, and that's important in context to take into consideration.
Yeah, absolutely. One of the things with Aniplex being a part of Bleach, and even Disney feeling that Bleach was worth all the money spent, it's one thing to believe that it is, it's another to have numbers back it up. And like you said, even though it's not the most important thing in the world, knowing that your investment was actually good by looking at these Blu-rays and saying, we made it this expensive and people still bought it. For Aniplex, for Shueisha, for Piro, and for Disney, that's good, because they're going to value Bleach all the more. And hey, I don't know if people know this, but Aniplex can be quite cutthroat if they don't believe you're profitable.
Ooh, so seven deadly sins.
Yeah, like, it's not a joke. Like, if they don't think you're profitable, get in the axe. So this is great for Bleach.
If we keep on this trajectory, it's possible that we could get something after the Parasite Blue War arc. I'm not going to say that we will, but you know, if we keep with the positive stuff, then I would say it's pretty confident.
Hey, if Aniplex wants money, if they like money and they like making money and making profits on their investment, we're proven to them that Bleach is the place to be. That's all that matters as far as I'm concerned.
Kubo does be bringing in that bread. Let's get into the second most important topic into this as well. And that is, the other day, the Club Outside, or Taikubo's is Twitter page, dropped a very surprising tweet. And this is regards to after people had kind of gaslit the community. The whole community kind of gaslit themselves, to be honest, thinking that there was going to be a preview at the end of the special screening of the Blu-ray event that happened quite recently on the 7th of May. Obviously, we expected a PV. I was kind of on the fence, but, you know, there was an excuse for a PV, I think is the right. better word to say things, right? There was an opportunity, and right. it wasn't taken and it wasn't given to us. So a lot of people were kind of disappointed until later that night, actually, where we did actually get a tweet from Tite Official saying a distribution program called Crew B Inside that dissimulates information about Tite Kubo's or Mr. Kubo's works has started on the YouTube Jump channel. The latest information on Bleach and Burn the Witch will be released. And before I get your thoughts, Rebirth, because this is really interesting, is that this is going to be on the Jump channel. And this is going to have, and correct me if I'm wrong, this is going to have Kubo and Taguchi?
Yes, I believe I saw that article. It was Bleach. I mean, Kubo and Taguchi will be at the May 28th event.
Right, so this is interesting. Yeah, as you said, May 28th. So this is interesting because this is going to be on the Shonen Jump channel. And that tells me that this is definitely going to have some sort of manga announcements to some sort of degree. Anyways, it would be on an Aniplex channel.
Oh, good point.
For sure. And that's just things that I've seen over time. Like, that's kind of like the census that I've got from it anyway of why would it be on Jump. And Jump did it for the 20th anniversary of Bleach 2. They did it on their YouTube channel, which was the manga for Burn the Witch and obviously the Thousand Year Blood War arc announcement and whatnot. So it's interesting, but that's why Taguchi being there is also interesting as well. So my hypothesis on this, and I want to start off with Burn the Witch. Now, if you guys don't know, in 2022 there is a newsletter that goes out for Club Outside members, and in 2022 there was it was January 2022, and if I can find the screenshot, I'll put it up just to reiterate. There was supposed to be some Burn the Witch news in 2022. We never got that Burn the Witch news, unless you want to count the swimsuit figures, then we didn't really get any news whatsoever. And people have always asked me, do I think Burn the Witch is done? Do you think he'll carry on? I do think Burn the Witch is done. I think the drafts are done. I think they're kind of planning on how to market it and how to release it and what campaigns they want to do to release it. So I do think this is going to be strongly, to me anyway, a continuation of Burn the Witch season 2, and we'll probably get a release date on that, or a teaser or a PV like we did for the Jumps for the Bleach 20th anniversary. Like we got the movie and obviously the manga. So I do think we're going to get a PV. That's going to be exciting. I can't wait to see Nini again on the screens. Are we going to get an anime like we did before? I don't think so. Unless they want to keep doing the movie route, I would prefer a series route, but that's a conversation for another time when something actually comes into fruition. So Burn the Witch, I can confidently say that I think... why mention Burn the Witch if you're not going to do anything with it, right? Exactly, what's there to bring out with Burn the Witch? So, you know, do you agree? What do you think about that?
I certainly do have to agree. When it comes to Burn the Witch, what else is there to market or to talk about if not the manga? And I, for one, really, really enjoyed Burn the Witch for what it was. I thought it was Kubo going back, I don't know, going old school with the way he was building out the world and how different he was. The storytelling style was sort of different in the way that was going. So I've been patiently waiting for some more Burn the Witch. Obviously, I'm biased for Bleach over Burn the Witch, but we don't have to pick one or the other. We're in a very cool situation where we can actually enjoy the best of both and hopefully a crossover down the line. And so if Kubo has an idea to bring us more Burn the Witch, I, for one, I'm going to be very excited to see what he has for us. Because Burn the Witch is a very good manga. It's Kubo doing what Kubo does best. And I can't wait for more.
Yeah, and I've always said as well that I do believe the Hell arc and Burn the Witch are simultaneously within the same time frame of the events happening. So I do think doing Burn the Witch before even touching the Hell arc is very beneficiary and important. As much as people probably won't notice it now, I generally do think the events of whatever happened in the Bleach world will affect Burn the Witch. So again, I think it's all about Kubo's a madman for doing two series at once in retrospect, if you think about that. So to do two different dimensions or two different different side stories or whatever you want to call it happening simultaneously is an amazing feat, as well as the anime. And we should talk about the anime because, as I said, this is on the Jump Channel, but we've got Taguchi with us. So there's two ways you can go about this, which, again, are we going to get a PV? And if not a PV, what are we going to get? Before I give my thoughts on that, actually, I'll throw it over to you on this one.
I'm not as intellectually inclined to the business side of the anime industry as you are. For me, with the little that I've known and the knowledge I've accrued over the years, I think this would be a good time to do so. It's the end of May. Bleach comes back in July. There's a screening in June. I expect them to have a preview for us or a trailer during the screening event that happens in June. And so having something like this in May, it makes sense. I think getting one in May, getting like short stuff, or even if we get the short stuff in May and then the major one in June, that's fine. But getting something in May, getting something in June, and then getting the main anime in July, I think will be important to keeping the hype train going. And the more Kubo there is out there for me, the better things are. I need Kubo everything. Burn the Witch and his exhibition and trailers and Bleach and Hell Arc manga, everything Kubo, get him everywhere. I'm all for it. So I think we're going to get a trailer or key visual, if nothing else.
I think both. And the reason why I say this is like 25th of May, you know, let's talk about the 25th of June, right? Which is the pre-screening, right? It's like how many, because we don't even know when in July it's going to come out. Let's just say it's going to be the 10th of July like it was in October, right? Let's just say the 10th. That is like just above 2 weeks until the main series comes out, right? And through that time, you're probably going to be wanting to do mini teaser trailers, right? Like they did before. Most animes do little teaser or little short trailers, right? So that 2 weeks is probably going to be spent doing little teasers, right? So this is the perfect time for May 25th to have that PV, because that's a good month where people get hyped, they get excited, and then they get given little breadcrumbs until the big reveal, so to say, of Core 2. And that's why I'm very confident that, like, I think the PV and the key visual is going to be on the 25th of May, because, again, they've made this a big deal. You know, and again, Taguchi's on it. It's like, well, why would Taguchi be on this live stream if he's got nothing to present? I mean, let's look at the worst case scenario. What, are we going to have another Q&A? Are we going to have, like, another talk like they did at, like, Anime Expo in New York, where they talk about how productions go in, have Morita say something which hasn't been told to us, obviously, or we're gonna have like a Q&A of what happened in like Core 1. It's like, no, they're gonna want to promote Core 2. So this is what I mean. It's like I definitely feel like there will be talks about Core 2, and then at the end it will show the key visual and then the preview, and then Kubo will say, you know, his thoughts, he'll do his laugh and troll smile as he does, and then so on and so forth.
Yeah, you make a very good point. And actually, just to piggyback off what you just said, in reference to if we assume that we do get something like absolutely at that screening event and the anime debuts, let's just say 10th of July, it's only about a couple of weeks. If that is the first time we're seeing the trailer 2 weeks before it airs, that would be bad.
And yeah, that's so some Viz marketing. Even,
right. That would be even more reason to believe that this May 28th, it has to be the first, because in that instance, at least you're giving yourself like a month's runway of building to something. Debuting a trailer at the event is just way too close.
Absolutely. And then to end it all off, we're going to be talking about Hell Arc, just slightly, just to throw it in there, just because I can throw it in the title. There was a very interesting translation on a Q&A for Club Outside, and his translation says, the question was, sorry, it seems that Lisa's influence has made you addicted to gyaru, which is a type of fashion for females in Japan, if you guys don't know, the gyaru style, or Yuyu Hara, from the Hell Arc, she's a gyaru, but what did you like before that, meaning what type of style did you like before that? And Kubo does reply that it wasn't a gyaru, but I might write about what it was like later, so I'll keep it quiet. Again, translation's a bit dodge, but again, this is interesting because what's he gonna write about? Is he gonna put, like, granted, we could say it's like gonna be in Burn the Witch, but he's talking specifically about Lisa and about the Bleach verse. So it's like he's going to write more about Bleach, but he's keeping it quiet, and that's because, well, why else would you keep something quiet? It's because you're doing something related to Bleach that you can't say. Or, you know, if you wanted to do an illustration, he'd just do it on the gallery, right? He'd do it on the website gallery. If he wanted to, if it wasn't that big of a deal, he'd just say it in the Q&A. And he's not going to put it in the Blood War arc. He's not going to put it in Burn the Witch because it's not relevant to Burn the Witch. So he's going to do it in the Hell arc. So the Hell arc is also, I would confidently say as well, it's been worked on as well. So,
I mean, we know that for a fact. Yeah, Kubo has said how, you know, it may be very short and very slow, but he's definitely working on it.
To not drag this video on too long, you know, people did do post about his comment about him doing like five pages in like a few months or whatever, right? And that's because he says he didn't want to work on a schedule, but he come to learn that working on a schedule, he needs to be forced to. And knowing Nakano, he's probably hit the old whip and said, come on, Kubo, get to work, right? And I think he has been a lot more productive since the anime and whatnot. So, you know, he has been busy and I think he has been not really slacking as he'd like to, but Kubo is the type of guy that I think needs to be told or nudged what to do, otherwise he'll take advantage of it. And I think it's in a playful way, not in like a demanding way that people may think is the case. But again, Hell Arc, what do you think about that? You think that that's the case, yeah?
Absolutely. I do think that this will have something to do with Hell. I think all the signs are there. The way Kubo's answering the question, the connection with Lisa, which again, like you said, puts us into the Bleach world, and its connection to Yu Yu Hara, a Hell Arc character specifically, I think all roads lead to Hell, which is a funny thing to say, but in Bleach's context, it makes me very excited to use that catchphrase. All roads lead to Hell.
Ooh. That's a chapter title, that is, man. I like that one. Right, so tell us what you guys think in the comment section down below about these news. What do you think of the sales? What do you think about Burn the Witch? What do you think about Bleach and the Hell Arc? And are you going to be there for the live stream on the 25th of May? Do you think it's going to be a PV? So, that being said, I want to thank my boy Flame of Rebirth.
I'm here wherever Kubology needs me. Oh, I'm here. God. All right. One day James will join us for sure. He's fighting it, but one day.
I invented it anyway. I'm gonna catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. Been Hanson, as always, people. Peace out, and of course, subscribe to Rebirth as well in the description down below. Peace.